The following Let's Play has been rated for mature audiences only. Any attempts to break the game are for entertainment value only. However, if any typos happen to be found... Hello, everyone! Welcome back to this game! When we last left off, I got a mansion. Yes, I am a 16-year-old girl who has her own mansion now. I still can't get over that. And I have my own staff. Last time I did not completely talk to my staff, I just got their introductory messages, and now I am going to continue talking to them. Actually, on that note, I'm going to talk to a lot of people today, because Obright has been giving me a heck of a lot of information that's kind of hard to take it all in. I should have written it all down, but I didn't really feel like writing all of that down. I remember some of it. What I don't remember, I'll go over as we go along, or something like that. But among the things that he told me, one of them was that I should talk to everybody in town while I still got the chance, because apparently after I finished the first main quest of the game, whatever quest that happens to be, in this case it's looking like it'll be the archaeology quest, then I am going to grow up again, become a full-grown woman, and all the little introductory chats that I have with these people are going to go away because I am no longer a teenager. So I should totally talk to everybody now while I have the chance. So let's talk to my staff here, and you know, is there any reason that I have this place? I mean, besides the fact that I have all these spots where I'm going to get awards for completing quests, but other than that, does this place have a purpose? Am I going to have other people living here? That's another thing that Obright told me. Everybody who can live in town is already in town, apparently. I guess that person was just talking about people moving here just for story's sake. But I have the opportunity to talk to everybody in town for the most part. Just have to wait for certain times of day with a few of them. Also, I am recording this after work. It is kind of supposed to be my bedtime, but I decided this is the best opportunity I'm going to be able to get to it this week. Not entirely sure that this is the greatest idea, because I'm kind of not thinking completely well. Anyway, let's do the talking to these people now while I'm still here. Or something. You see what I mean? Let's see, what would you do? Weather forecast, decorate. Okay, there we go. Buy decorations with int points. You know, that answers one question. What else are int points for? Because int points got me this mansion, and now I can get child information. Okay, let's ask about that. This is something you might consider once you have found a partner to help you raise a child. Okay. What about weather forecast? West Moyo's forecast. Tomorrow will be sunny with seasonal temperatures. Decorate. It seems as though you have not run across anything to display yet. Keep your eyes open for anything nice to decorate your home with. Alright, well, I don't have any int points, so, I won't be able to buy anything yet. Alright, what about you? Let's change the music in here. Alright. I agree, let's play something else. What are you in the mood for? Soothing and relaxing? Somber? Let's go with this, bright and cheerful. I guess that's the song that's playing right now. Oh, sorry, I can't right now. I'm working. If I hear some really good music, I'll be worthless for the rest of the day. Oh, was I asking her to play music, or is this like the Musicians Guild sort of thing? Let's try changing the music again. Alright, so that song was the playful one. Let's get some info. If you're musically inclined, there are 10 music fans in this town that would love to have somebody to go listen to at the music hall. There was a band here called Shivak for years, but they left right about the time the shops and restaurant closed. They gave up, but you don't have to. Just think, we're an untapped market for just waiting for the next new musical idol. It's like I read these typos and then I get tongue-tied and... that kind of ruins the effect of the typo. Or maybe it adds to it. I don't know. Help! That's okay, I'd hate to bother anybody over something so trivial. Was I offering to help her? Alright, well, I guess that's all I can really do here. So it's gonna be sunny or something like that, right? I don't know. So let's see here. What is with these barriers, RPG Maker 3 developers? Like, you couldn't, like, add one more polygon to the wall here so I can go across it at an angle? No, it has to be a complete square. Also, there's smoke coming out of that chimney. I never noticed that before. Kind of an interesting effect. Actually, it's not really all that interesting. It's more like round circles. Oh wait, maybe they have a shape to them. Somebody once commented that I pay way too much attention to detail while I'm let's playing. Oh well. So I talked to her already. She's that bratty girl who was my bully in the orphanage. Hey, where is the orphanage anyway? After looking in the editor, I know that the Moyos is pretty much the only town. So where is the orphanage if it's not a town in a separate town, or it's not in this town, and there's no separate town, so of course it's not in a separate town. Maybe I'll find it eventually. No, it's gotta be here somewhere, because it's how the building editor works. You place a building and that automatically creates the inside. You cannot create the inside of a building without having the outside placed somewhere. Oh, wait a sec. I wonder. There's this building over here. Maybe that's the orphanage. Can't really go in it, so I can't find out unless I go into the editor. Anyway, let's talk to this person, because we haven't talked to this person yet. It's probably worthwhile to talk to everybody anyway, because apparently my character here actually knows everybody in town. So, you know, I'd like to actually know everybody in town. Her name is Hope. How's it going, Zoe? See these fish in this pond? I wish. That would be a nice little effect for RC Maker 3. Well, I'm working on an invention to attract the fish into a trap. Another inventor, huh? I'll show that Chester. I wanted to be an apprentice under him, but Marley beat me to it. Oh well, he'll feel a sting when I invite everybody in town to my big fish fry, except him. I'm fine, Hope, thanks. And don't feel bad. You never know. I'm sure Chester would have picked you if you had been there sooner. I've been looking at these fish for a long time now, and I had no idea all this time that they were good to eat. I guess that's not usually something you think about. It's like, ooh, look at the pretty fish, and not so much, ooh, look at my next meal. Unless you're a cat. Or a bear. Yeah, these fish are really good to eat, actually. And most of them are a good size for eating. Oh, and yeah, I was kidding about Chester. He's aight. Is that a dual pro reference? That can't be a dual pro reference. It was nice of you to say that, though. I was also told to check some other information on these characters. I was kind of wanting to avoid that because, like, some of the information they give me might be relevant to a quest, and I'd want to actually look into that later, and I didn't want it to be redundant, me looking at the same messages a second time, but who knows, maybe some of these discussions will go away after I grew up. So, once again, RPG Maker 3 is being stupid with the camera. Man, that chick named Marla over there. You know her, right? It still freaks me out every time I look at her. Dude! Okay, I told you about the first time I ever met her, when she told me I was only useful as an organ donor, right? Wow, yep, that's Marla, alright. Well, ever since then, I've just kind of ignored her. But then I started seeing her looking in that darn window. All the time! Man, that's just weird. Which window? Of her own mansion, or of the mansion that I just bought? Yes, I definitely know Marla. She and I grew up together. She was never nice to me. She cut my hair off on more than one occasion. But this one time really took the cake. I came home early from a party one night and caught her taking a letter from my box. It had my name on it, but I never got to read it. She took it and destroyed it. I never got mail. Oh well. Wow, Marla's a jerk. You know, I'm gonna go over there and be a prick to her. Well, my, fate certainly dealt us different cards, didn't it? It's given me a message that I already read once. I'm pretty sure I saved. After all, I got the mansion. Well, I have the option to steal from her, but I don't want to be that cruel to her. Oh, by the way, trading. You know how I could have the option of trading her this one piece of equipment for an invention in exchange for a piece of cooking equipment? Well, as it turns out, since I scanned this piece of equipment for the invention, that means I can trade this in and I can still use the invention for the thing. And how does that work? Like, just by scanning it, that automatically makes it usable for the invention even if I don't have it? Is he, like, scanning it so that he knows how to build it in case it's lost again? Let's see. Oh, I already did this. Alright, so, apparently after chatting with her and her talking about how I stole the mansion from her, that's what triggers this message, apparently. Anything else I can get from you? Did I do chat or info? I forget. Alright, so it was chat, so let's get some info. Hey, don't tell anybody that I told you this, okay? Well, a while ago, Chester and his dad had a fight about one of his inventions. Max wound up going to jail that night for public drunkenness, and the next day the parts of that invention were missing. I think at least some of the parts are around the jail, but the night that they let Max out, he also went to church, so who knows? Interesting. See, this is what I'm talking about, how I didn't want to be talking with these people before I'm ready to go on certain quests, because this is information relevant to the trading quest, the invention quest, and I'm not really ready to continue that quest yet. So, I'm gonna hope that getting info is not really relevant just yet, but I can at least chat. Or by that I mean info. I'm hoping that the info they gave me doesn't change after I grow up. So let's see, this is the place I would have lived had I kept that other file, and of course the door is locked. So I imagine there's going to be some places that aren't locked, so let me just check around for houses and see who I can go into. I think I already tried this house when I was trying to figure out which house was my own. And this is Max's house. Is anybody here? His wife, I guess? Zoe Head. That name! Well, just look at you. I just cannot believe how you've grown. I remember when you first moved here into that house next to us. You hardly ever left the house, and then you were in school all those years. I've hardly seen you. What have you been up to? Oh, and how is that nice Mr. Magoo? My father is fine. We've both been so busy lately that we hardly ever see each other anymore. I also have not seen you or your husband Max much either. You're right about school. It took up a lot of my time. Now I have the key to the house, though, and I have to find a job. Maximilian has always been so kind to me. Is there no way I can help in one of his shops? Max always spoke so highly of you. I'm sure he would love to have you work for him. Unfortunately, now is not a good time for us. I don't know if you've heard, but Max had to close all three of his shops here in town. He has some money put away for such a time, but the old fool's gone and forgotten where he did it. Our two sons are good boys. Maybe you could help them to help Max. Yeah, I could. Or I could chat with you. Oh, this person wants her portrait. Oh, that's right. I was going to make a decision about whether to continue the archaeology quest and go out into the world and fight monsters, or try out being an artist. I'll decide on that later. I'm getting old. So I'm sorry if I already told you this, but I'm so glad you didn't turn out like that boy from Warren Hall. Oh, what was his name? He had flaming red hair. Oh, Lance! That was it. He used to wash our windows for pocket money until I heard him yelling awful things at those wood elves who live here from our porch. I was so embarrassed, he never came here again. Wood elves. I'm gonna have to hunt around for a wood elf. Maybe that's a nighttime character. He was definitely a bully, make no mistake, but he was always too busy starting fights with other boys to try and impress the girls. When there were no boys around, his little brother got it. But I'm over all that now. Oh, so, that's the older kid who came in later in the scene in the beginning of the game. Nice to know that we're over it. Forgive and forget. Oh yeah, I came into this house before and nobody was here, so apparently the old lady there is a daytime character. Speaking of daytime, it's not going to be long before it's no longer daytime. Alright, we've been to Chester's house before. Have we chatted with him yet? Let me check that. Alright, so here's a message that I haven't read yet. Chester's not so bad, at least not nearly as bad as his father seems to think. Sure, he's a lazy slob, but he leaves me alone and lets me work in peace, which is great. Plus, he's patient with me when I screw up something, which is even better. I wish things were better between those two. He gets grumpy when they've been fighting. It makes me sad to see them that way also. It seems like such a shame. How can Maximilian not see that Chester is intelligent and kind? Look at all of the things he's invented. He just needs to find the right thing to impress his father. I agree. Also, it's evening now. I don't know what this means for talking with people. I'll have to test this. I'll go to this place over here. I know that these people over here disappear whenever it comes to nighttime, so let's see if they're here. Yeah, they're here. Alright, so evening doesn't count as night. That's good to know. You know, it's a good thing I'm decided to go ahead and chat with everybody because I can't remember who I've talked to yet. I mean, I know I talked to the dwarf here, but I don't remember if I chatted with him or if I went straight to the trading. Alright, well, he doesn't chat. Let's check help. Nah, that's okay. If I can defeat Miss Mercer, then I can solve this little problem. I have no idea what you're talking about. Alright, haven't been in this house yet. Maddie's house! Are you home, Maddie? There's a little kid here. Are you Maddie? There's a treasure chest. Are you Maddie? Or maybe this person. Let's talk to this person first. Well, hey there, Zoe girl. How are you doing today? I'm doing fine, Maddie, thanks. And I'm glad to see that you and Logan are doing well. I think I might like to have a child of my own one day, but right now I have to find a paying job. You haven't heard about anything, have you? A job? Well, here's what I know about jobs in town. First, there's the artists and musician guilds. Then there's the church, the reward for work that you do for them. Also, there's the academy, Max's shops. Althea might need some help, and Zinnia might need some help with the restaurant. Ever since Urban died, my full-time job has been feeding that bottomless pit over there. I have a bottom, Mama! See? Logan! Nobody wants to see your bottom, but if you don't go back downstairs right now, ships way out on the sea will see the red glow coming from it. Oh, that's clever. I like that. What about you? You are just standing there. On that note, why don't people walk around? It is an option. In fact, at the very beginning of the game, Max was walking around. But now people are just standing around. It doesn't take extra memory to have a person walk around. Hey Zoe, she said I didn't have a bottom. Hehe, I'm sure you're just misunderstanding. Nuh-uh, she's crazy, and I told her she was crazy. I jumped off the stairs and I was all ZOW! And she was scared and ran away. My mom is crazy and so are you. I'm going away to school next year and I'm getting away from all you crazy people. And you can't do four choices with this guy. Well, let's do four choices with the mother. Help? What is with help? Is this relevant to anything? It's okay. I've managed this long on my own since my husband died. I'll keep managing somehow. I always do. Eventually, I'm gonna find a person where help is relevant to something. Is this open? Yay! Seafood! So it's a key item. Was there a treasure chest up there? I think there was. I'm glad this doesn't, like, count against me or anything. Sesame oil. That reminds me. That's like my second sesame oil, isn't it? I'm not sure, but the int metals, as it turns out, key items don't stack, because back when I did Light in the Sky, I had two bombs and I used one and they were both gone. Well, the reason why I was able to use two int metals is because Obrite is keeping track of how many I have separate from the key item list. Alright, let's see if I can talk to anybody else before it becomes nighttime. There's a couple houses I haven't gone into yet. Firstie's house. That's probably a possible home. I assume any place that is locked is a possible place where I would have been adopted. Alright, so now it is about to turn night. So I'm just gonna wait a moment and see if anybody is going to appear once it becomes night. Actually, first I'm going to go here and see if there's like any option to chat with these two in here real quick. Hopefully I can get to them before it's officially... Apparently it doesn't have to say that it's nighttime in order for it to count as nighttime. That's confusing. So I guess since now it is technically night, yeah, those two people are gone. I remember in the map editor it said that there were three people on this map, but I've only seen two, so the third person must be a nighttime only person. Gonna look around and see if I can figure out where that person is. So while I'm doing that, here's the title of the next episode. I'll see you then.